The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 30, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 31st, 1973, in London, England.
Translation: O descendant of Bharata, he who dwells in the body is eternal and can never be slain. Therefore, you need not grieve for any creature.
Dehi nittam avadhoyam, dehi sarvasya bharat. Dehi means body. Within the body, this topic began. Dehi nasmin yatha dehi kaumara yovanam jara. Deha dehi. Dehi means one who possesses the body. Just like guni, ostatte in pratta, grammatical. Guna in, deha in pratta, dehin sabda. So, the nominative case of dehin sabda is dehi. Dehi nityam, itana. In so many ways, Krishna has explained. Nittam itara, indestructible, immutable. It does not take birth, it does not die. It is always constantly the same. Nahannati hannamani sarire. In this way, again he says, Nittam itara abhodayam. Nobody can kill, and the body is there. But dehi sarvasya bharata, this is very important. Not that simply in human body the soul is there, and not in other body, that is rasakarma. Sarvasya, in every body, even within the ant, even within the elephant, even in the gigantic banyan tree, or within the microbe, sarvas. The soul is there. But some rascals, they say, the animals have no soul. This is wrong. How you can say the animal has no soul? Everyone, here, the authoritative statement by Krishna, sarvas. And in other place, Krishna says, sarva-yonishu kaunteya, sambhavanti murtaya. In all species of life, as many forms are there, 8,400,000 different forms of life. Tasam mahajani brahma, mahajani. That source of body is of this material nature. Aham abhijapadapita, I am the seed-giving father. And without father and mother, there is no offspring. So the father is Krishna, and the mother is material nature, or spiritual nature. There are two natures. That is explained in the seventh verse. The material nature and the spiritual nature. Or the superior nature or inferior nature. Just like in our body, there are inferior parts and superior parts. Body is the same, but still there are different parts of the body. Some of them are considered as inferior and some of them are considered superior. Even two hands, according to Vedic civilization, right hand is the superior hand and left hand is the inferior. When you want to give somebody something, you must give it with the right hand. If you give it by the left hand, it is insult. Two hands are equal. Why this hand is superior to this hand? So we have to accept the Vedic injunction. So although both the nature, The spiritual nature and material nature is coming from the same source, absolute truth. Janmardasya-jataha, everything is emanating from him. Still, there is inferior nature and superior nature. What is the difference between inferior and superior? In the inferior nature or in the material nature, God consciousness is almost nil. Those who are in the modes of goodness, they have little God consciousness. And those who are in the modes of passion, they have got less degree. And in those who are in the modes of ignorance, there is no God consciousness. Completely absent. Degrees. Therefore, this body, although this is material coming from the same source, still it is inferior. So when the Dehi or the spirit soul, although by nature it is superior than the material nature, but still, because he is encased within the material nature, he is forgetful of Krishna. This is the cause. But as it is stated here, that Dehe Sarvasya Dehe, the same spirit is there. Therefore, those who are not rascals, those who are intelligent and in complete knowledge, they do not find any distinction between a human being or an animal. Pandita Samadarshina, because he's Pandit, he's learned, he knows that the spirit soul is there, vidya-vinaya-sampanni-brahmani. Within the first-class learned Brahmin, there is the soul, the same quality soul, vidya-vinaya-sampanni-brahmani, gobi in the cow, hastini in the elephant, suniche, with the dog, chandale, the lowest kind of human being, everywhere the soul is there. It is not that simply in a human being there is soul, or in higher demigods there is soul, and poor animals have no soul. No, everyone has. Dehi sarvasya bharat. So whom we shall accept? The statement of Krishna, or some rascal philosopher, or some so-called religionist? Whom we shall accept? We shall have to accept Krishna, the supreme authority, the supreme being. He says, sarvasya. Many places, Krishna says. Therefore, those who are learned, they do not make such distinction that it has no soul. Everyone has got soul. Tasma sarvani bhutani. Again he says, sarvani bhutani. Natam suchitam marhasi. It is your duty. Krishna is simply stressing on the point that the soul is eternal, it cannot be killed. In so many ways, the body is perishable. So it is your duty now to fight. The body may be killed, body may be destroyed, but no hannate hannamane sarire. But even after the destruction of this body, the soul exists. He gets another body, that's all. Deha, tatha dehantara prati. Dehantara prati. He must get another body. And this will be explained in the next verse also. For a kshatriya who are engaged in fighting in religious fight. Fight must be religious fight. The cause must be right. Then the fighting is all right. The kshatriya killing in the religious fight, he is not responsible, he is not sinful. That is stated. Just like Brahmana, he puts in sacrifice some animal. That does not mean he is killing. Similarly, Kshatriya, when he is engaged in killing, he is not sinful. This will be explained in the next verse. So it is your duty, don't be worried that you are killing your kinsman or your grandfather. Take it from me, assurance that the dehi yabadhyam, you cannot kill, is eternal. Now, dehi sarvasya bharata, this important point, you should note it, that every living entity, the body has grown on the platform of the spirit soul. The body may be very gigantic or very small, it doesn't matter. Therefore, matter is produced or grows on the platform of spirit. Not that a spirit comes into existence or living force comes into existence by the combination of matter. This is a scientific point. Matter is dependent on spirit, therefore it is called inferior. Jaidam dharjate jagat. Dharjate. It bears. The spirit is there, therefore the gigantic universe is resting on the spirit. Either the Supreme Spirit, Krishna, or the small spirit. There are two kinds of spirit. Atma and Paramatma. Ishara and Parameshwara. The matter is explained by Krishna. Aparayam itastu vidhimi prakitim para jayedam dharya jiva bhuta mahava jayedam dharyate jagat. So spirit is bearing. Everything is explained in Bhagavad Gita. These gigantic, big planets, why it is floating, weightless, in the air. That is also explained. Gama visya hum dharayami, ojasa dharayami. That just try to understand a big 747 aeroplane taking 500-600 passengers is floating, flying in the sky without any difficulty. Why? Because the pilot is there, not the machine. Don't think that it is a gigantic machine, therefore it is flying. No, the pilot is there. Machine is there also. But the floating is depending not on the mechanical arrangement, but on the pilot. Is there any disagreement? If the pilot is not there, the whole machine immediately falls down. Immediately. Similarly, the statement in the Bhagavad Gita, Gama Vishwa Hamojusa, Krishna enters into the gigantic planet. He is within the Annantarastham Paramanuchayantarastham. This is stated in the Brahma Sangita. Eka pasaurachayatam jagadanna koti jachakti rasti jagadanna chayajadam tam annantarastham paramanu chayantarastham govindamadi purushottam tamamaya. Without Krishna's entering into the matter, nothing can work. Annantarastham, within this universe, he is there, as Garbhodha Kasai Vishnu. Therefore the universe exists. Annantarastham. And within the universe, there are so many material, I'm going to say, identity, entities. Even this atom The Shastra says, even within the atom, he as Paramatma, he is within the body of everyone. Not only within the body of living entities, but he is within the Paramatma, the atom. They are studying now atomic energy. Still they are finding difficulty, dividing, because they cannot find out that there is God, there is Krishna. So, without Krishna's, presence, nothing can exist. Therefore, one who is advanced Krishna conscious, he sees only Krishna, not the outward covering. Because without Krishna, nothing can exist. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita it is said, Thavara Jangam Dakhe. There are two kinds of entities, moving and not moving. Moving means sthavar, and moving means jangam. Sthavar jangam. Sthavar means not moving. There are two kinds of entities. So you can see these two kinds of entities. Some of them are moving, some of them are not moving. But a Mahabhagavat sees both the entities, moving and not moving, but he does not see the moving or not moving. He sees Krishna. Because he knows that the moving means living force. So living force, that is also Krishna's energy. And the non-moving is material, that is also Krishna's energy. So, in everything he sees only Krishna. Premanjana charita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva ridayesu vilopayanti. Sadaiva. They sometimes inquire, have you seen God? Those who are actually devotees, advanced devotees, he is simply seeing Krishna, nothing else. Premanjana charita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva ridayesu. Sadaiva means always. Ridayesu vilokayanti yam shama sundaram achinta gunasarupam govindamadi purusam tamaham vajami. This is more you advance in Krishna consciousness, you'll simply see Krishna. And if you become practiced to see Krishna always, sadātadbhāva-bhāvita jaga-jaga-bhāpi-smaran-loki tajat-tanti-kali-yadidad-bhāva. So, if you always think of Krishna, that is Krishna's instruction also. Manmanābhava-mad-bhakta-mad-jājima-agana-muskuru. Always think of that is the first-class yogi who thinks of Krishna always. Yogi-nāma-pi-sarvesāṁ madgata-antarātmanā bhajate-yomā Samirukta-tamama. He is first-class yogi. And devotee is, we already, otherwise why he should think of Krishna? Manmana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji. One, only bhaktas can think of Krishna always. Manmana bhavamad bhakta. Because you are my bhakta, your duty is to think of me always. It is a very difficult task. You are seeing Krishna in the temple, the more you see Krishna, 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 24 hours engagement in Krishna consciousness means you will be practiced to see Krishna always. This is Krishna consciousness movement. You cannot forget Krishna, even for a moment. And that is the instruction. Mano na bhava mad bhakta madhyaji mag namaskur. These four things. When there is deity in the temple, you see it and get the impression, when out of the temple also, you can see within your heart. If you have developed love for Krishna, otherwise, officially you come to the temple and as soon as botheration, let me forget you. That is another thing. But the whole process is meant for developing love for Krishna. Sabai pumsan parvo dharma jato bhakti radhokhaje. Bhakti radhokhaje. That is first class religion system. This is first class religion system. This Krishna consciousness is the first class topmost religious system. Why? It is educating people to think of Krishna, the Supreme Lord, always. Loving, not only thinking. You cannot think of anyone unless you love. If you love somebody, then you can think of him, always. Just like both lover and beloved, say one boy, another girl. So they are in love. So both of them think of both of them, always. When we shall meet again, when we shall meet again. So similarly, manmana bhavad bhakta, you can become a devotee of Krishna, you can think of Krishna always, provided you have developed love for Krishna. Premanjana churita, bhakti vilacha. By bhakti, you can develop your love for Krishna. That is required. So, in the lower stage of animal life, Krishna is there, as you say, Dehi Sarvasya Bharata. In another place, Krishna says, this Dehi or Khetragna, the owner of the body, is there. And there is another Khetragna, another owner. That is Krishna. Khetragancha api maga vidhi sarva khetreshu bhārata. As the individual soul is there within the body. Similarly, the super soul, Krishna, is also there. Both of them there. Both of them there. So he is the owner of all bodies. All bodies. Sometimes Krishna is accused by the rascals that why he danced with his other's wife. But actually he is the proprietor. Dehi Sarvasya Bharata. I am not proprietor, he is the proprietor. So if the proprietor dances with his, med servants or devotees, what is the wrong there? What is the wrong? He is the proprietor. You are not proprietor. Dehi Sarvasya Bharata. The individual soul is in every body, and the super soul is the real proprietor. Krishna said, Bhaktaram Jagatavasam Sarva Loka Maheshara. Maheshara, he is the supreme proprietor. Suridam Sarva Bhutana, he is actual friend. If I have some lovers, I am friend. I am not friend. Actual friend is Krishna. Suridam Sarva Bhutana, as it is said. Tasmat Sarvani Bhutana. Krishna is the real friend. So, if the gopis dance with the real friend, what is wrong there? What is wrong there? But those who are rascals, who do not know Krishna, they think it is immoral. It is not immoral. That is the right thing. Right thing. Krishna is the real husband. Therefore, he married 16,108 wives. Why 16,000? If he married 16 trillion, billion wives, what is wrong there? Because he is the real husband. Sarva Loka Maheshara. So one who does not know Krishna, rascal, they accuse Krishna as immoral or woman hunter, like that. And they take pleasure in this. Therefore they paint pictures of Krishna, his affairs with the gopi. But if they do not paint pictures, how he is killing Kamsa, how he is killing the demons, they do not like this. This is Sahaja. They, for their debauchery, for their business of debauchery, they likes to be supported by Krishna. Krishna has done this. Krishna has become immoral, so therefore we are also immoral. We are great devotees of Krishna because we are immoral. This is what is. Therefore, to understand Krishna, it requires a little better intelligence. Better. Bhavanam janmanamante. Gyanavan. Gyanavan means the first class intelligence, wise. Mahang prabandhate. He understands what is Krishna. Vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlava. Such kind of intelligent mahatma, you can find out rascal mahatma simply by changing dress without Krishna consciousness, declaring himself as God, as Krishna, kick on their face. Krishna is different from all these rascals. But if you understand Krishna, if you are so fortunate, eirupe brahmanda bhavite kono bhagyavanji, only the most fortunate person can understand Krishna. What is Krishna? There are many, many millions and trillions of living entities within this universe. And they are rotating in different species of life, 8,400,000. In this way, unfortunate, simply repetition, birth and death in different. Out of them, if one is the greatest fortunate, he is, when given the chance, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Lata. By the mercy of Guru and Krishna, he gets the seed of devotional service. And if he is intelligent, otherwise how he gets the seed, that is initiation. And if he waters, just like if you get a nice seed, you have to sow it and pour little water, then it will grow. Similarly, anyone who by great fortune has come into Krishna consciousness, the seed of devotional service, he should water it. And what is this water? Sravana kirtana jale karaya sechan. This is watering. This hearing and chanting about Krishna. This is water. Don't be absent from the class. This hearing and chanting is watering the seed of devotional service. If you make it official, and be absent from hearing. This is most important thing. Savanam Ketanam Vishnu. This is most important thing, to hear. Savanam Ketanam does not mean hearing and chanting of any other entity. No, Vishnu. Savanam Ketanam, the rascals they have manufactured, Kali Ketanam. No, where is in the Shastra there is Kali Ketanam, Shiva Ketanam? No. Ketanam means glorifying the Supreme Lord, Krishna. That is Kirtan. Not any other Kirtan. But they are man, competition. Kali Kirtan. Where is in the Shastra Kali Kirtan? Durga Kirtan. These are all nonsense. Simply Krishna. Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padu Seva. Krishna should be worshipped. Krishna should be heard. Krishna should be chanted. Krishna should be remembered. In this way, you'll advance Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.